3, 2, 1.
Hi, I'm Brianna.
And I'm Akira.
And you're watching
Dontaes Boxing Nation.
From 160 to 168, at Canelo Fanboy asks, which fighter is the best style to dethrone Canelo? I think probably Demetrius Andrade. I mean, Canelo may be the best middleweight in the world. I'd love to see Andrade get a shot. The guy can box. He's long. He's trouble for anybody.
Man, if I was him,
I think this is the guy I was supposed to debate. How you doing, Aki? 6'6". Yeah.
You can hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Oh yeah, what up? What up, Broham? What up with it? What up with it? How you doing?
Man, I thought you was gonna be a no show. Man, I thought you was trolling me on some Ryan Garcia Rolly.
Nah.
You know, I was like, man, my man, he done pulled a Cap 19 on me. What's going on? What's up with you?
Not even, man. We run for crime on these guys. It's different, bro. You know, we'll do a mix with the homie. You feel me? We be boxing and shit. You feel me?
I got you. Now, let the public know. Well, I'm going to let them know. You hit me up on Instagram saying that you want to debate one-on-one.
Because I do. Okay. It's real. You feel me? But I got to tell for you, family. You say Canelo be ducking, bro. Is that a fact? That's what you think?
That's not what I think. That's the truth. That's a fact. So,
that's the truth.
Yeah,
that's a fact. This is what I did. Here's the truth. Here's the fact, fam. No lie, he following the green print, fam. That's the green print Floyd laid out, bro.
Okay. So let me ask you this question. When is he going to start doing what Floyd Mayweather did throughout his career? Because it's a fact.
What do you mean as far as what? What do you mean exactly?
That's what I'm trying to figure out. You compare him to Floyd, which is a disrespect to Floyd Mayweather, because when is Canelo going to start doing what Floyd Mayweather did throughout his career? Floyd Mayweather, as pretty boy, he was the boogeyman. Canelo was never the boogeyman. That's first of all. So Floyd Mayweather, as pretty boy, he fought Corrales, Castillo, Oscar De La Hoya, Ricky Hatton, and
Zab,
Baldemir. But a lot of fighters avoided him at the same time, right? It wasn't until he became Money Mayweather where he became the A-side. But even then, he still fought the best. He fought Manny Pacquiao, who's still kicking ass to this day. You know what I'm saying?
100 years old.
Yeah. But Pacquiao got more cojones than Canelo.
That was a high-level exhibition.
Pacquiao old. He's 42 years old today, still kicking ass. He got more cojones than Canelo Alvarez, and that's a fact. So what I'm saying is Floyd Mayweather beat Pacquiao. Floyd Mayweather was older than Pacquiao. Floyd Mayweather challenged Pacquiao in his prime. It was Pacquiao who turned down the fight because of a drug test. Floyd Mayweather beat Canelo, Maidana, Cotto, Mosley, and the list goes on and on and on. So, since you compared Floyd Mayweather to Canelo Alvarez, Floyd Mayweather made a living.
The green print.
Yeah, Floyd Mayweather made a living.
The green print.
Floyd Mayweather made a living.
Not him, the game plan to get the bag. He getting the bag.
Okay. Well, that's what I'm saying. We're going to get to that. But Floyd Mayweather made a living of beating Mexican fighters. He told Oscar De La Hoya, you line him up and I beat him. I knock him down. So why doesn't Canelo return the favor and beat all the black fighters from Charlo, Andre, even Benavidez? So why he don't return the favor that Floyd Mayweather did beating up all these Hispanic fighters on Cinco de Mayo? Why doesn't Canelo do the same since you compared him to Floyd Mayweather?
I'm not comparing him to Floyd Mayweather. I'm comparing getting a bag to Floyd Mayweather. Floyd was fighting Berto.
That was Floyd Mayweather's retirement fight. Canelo is in his prime right now.
He retired, but then he fought Tommy.
Canelo is in his prime. Floyd Mayweather, you comparing him to after he beat Pacquiao, the fight of the century, then he fought Berto as a retirement fight. Right now, Canelo just fought.
Bag.
Ivini's the bag?
The bag.
Is Ivini the bag?
The bag, bro.
Is Ivini the bag?
Is Ivini the bag?
Fighting Ivini's for the bag?
How much he made for Ivini, bro?
$15 million? Less than that, probably. 15 or less.
How much did he get an endorsement for Ivini, bro? How much did he get in pay-per-view for the date for Ivini?
Okay, Canelo was offered $40 million plus to fight Demetrius Andrade for Undisputed at 160. Canelo said his dream is to become Undisputed at 160. And become the first middleweight of all time to be undisputed.
He did say that.
Thinking of the fact that he's fighting in June aside, can you give me your thoughts about the possibility of a fight against Demetrius Andrade and the prospect of becoming the undisputed champion?
Sí, no, el que tenga el título, eso es lo que queremos. Queremos el título, y pues obviamente ese es el objetivo, ¿no? Vamos a sentarnos con nuestro equipo a ver qué es lo que viene, pero el objetivo es ganar los cuatro títulos en peso medio.
Yes, that's the goal. Look, whoever has the title, doesn't matter. Our goal is to unify all the belts, become the undisputed middleweight champion of the world.
He did say that. He did say that.
He did say that, right?
Facts.
Okay. DAZN offered him $40 million guaranteed to fight Demetrius Andrade on DAZN. You say Canelo follows the Floyd Mayweather green print. You say Canelo fights for the bag. So why did he turn down his biggest offer, the biggest money he ever made in his entire career to this day? You keep talking about the bag. So explain to me why he fought Billy Joe Saunders, why he fought Iovine, why he fought Rocky Fielding for less money than Demetrius Andrade for the bag.
Say that last part again, Sam.
You said Canelo fights for the bag.
Say what you said after Billy Joe Saunders.
The question is very clear. You said Canelo fights for the bag, right?
The green print, man.
Okay.
He got the green print.
Okay, so
big
the green
bag,
print, okay.
left risk. Big green. Bag is left risk. It's okay, bank okay. Robbing.
Floyd Mayweather fought Pacquiao. That was a big risk.
That was what?
Floyd Mayweather fought Pacquiao. That was a big
risk.
That was
risk. Big risk?
Yeah.
I'm not going to disrespect nobody because we be boxing. You feel me? Instagram, they say I hit harder because I do. But, you know, there's boxing. But it's real, bro. You know it's going to be easy work.
Stop deflecting from the point. You said Canelo fights.
You know it's
going to
be easy work.
No. Pacquiao was no
easy work. About risk.
Pacquiao was no easy work. Was Canelo easy work for Floyd?
You're not going to say Pacquiao was easy work for Floyd? You don't think that was easy work?
That was the guy who was supposed to beat Floyd.
Who?
Pacquiao. That was the fighter that was supposed to beat Floyd. Okay, how about this?
Because
you keep deflecting. We know Pacquiao
wasn't there. I'm asking your question. Big bag, low risk.
So Pacquiao was low risk.
Easy work is low risk.
Was Canelo low risk for Floyd?
Are you kidding me? Do you know about boxing, family? I'm not even going to disrespect you on your own thing, bro. Easy work.
So who was a high risk for Floyd then?
Zab, Shane, back then. You feel me? Once you get A-side, bro, you know what you get A-side, you control.
Okay, hold on. Pause. You said Zab and Mosley was high risk?
They wasn't.
I want to confirm it. You saying Zab and Mosley was high risk for Floyd, right?
Like that, those fights back then was way higher risk, bro.
Did Floyd Mayweather fight them?
Yeah, he fought him.
Exactly. So why doesn't Canelo fight Andre?
Because he don't have to, bro. Big bag, low risk. Because I'm A-side. Get the money, Bankwell.
But
you hear Floyd, bro?
A-side? You contradicted yourself.
Canelo not A-side to Andre?
You contradicted yourself.
Canelo not A-side to Andre?
You contradicted yourself. Stop trolling.
Andre,
I'm going to have to mute you. I'm going to have to mute you if you keep trolling.
I'm answering your question.
You're deflecting.
I'm giving you the air.
You're digressing from my point. So don't cut me off. I'm about to talk.
Bro.
If you cut me off again, I'm going to mute you. I'm going to mute you because you keep cutting me off and I don't got time. Hey, but it's time for you to get this work on some loaded Lux work, though. I'm going to ask you the question again. I don't want you to tap out on me. You said Canelo Alvarez fights for the money. It's all about the green print. Then why did he duck Demetrius Andrade for Undisputed for his biggest payday of his career? Just like he gave up his belt to Charlo and avoided Benavidez to cherry pick Iovine. Why did Canelo turn down the biggest offer of his career if it's about the money, if it's about the green print? Take the stand.
You hear me?
You're going to get this work. That's what you're going to get.
But you're not even taking what I'm saying as a fact.
Can you answer the question? Why did Canelo follow the green print?
Don't you ever come to me disrespect, you big ass nigga from the east side of Pacoima, my arm.
Take your L and go elsewhere. You're showing you soft as hell because you emotionally attached. You talking out your a-hole. Opinions are like assholes. Everybody got one. You got a bigger opinion, but that doesn't make your opinion a fact. Like I said, that's why you got stuck. That's why you tapped out. You a pound-for-pound decaf on split decision. And you
don't know shit about boxing.
I lost brain cells talking to you. I lost brain cells talking to you. And that's what's up with these keyboard warriors that's thugs online.
Yeah, what's up, Aki? It's Kiernan from Albany, New York.
Man, my apologies. I had to put you on hold because this man, we scheduled a date. We scheduled an appointment for him to call in the debate. And you saw how he started trolling. He started talking about how he hit softest. He got stuck so bad. Like, I understand. Look, if you're going to tap out, just wave the white flag and acknowledge the point. You don't got to get mad. You don't got to get emotional like a female. That's what he showed. He just showed that he is a man with no cojones, a man that needs to get cojones implanted. Because only a man with no cojones is going to defend another man with no cojones. It's a clear duck. The man got stuck. And now he over here acting gangster on split decision. He's emotionally attached to a fighter that he couldn't even defend. Canelo ain't even defending himself over ducking Andrade and Charlo and Benavidez. He told them, you a horrible fighter. You made it to the horrible fighter list. That's the reason why he ducked him. What he means by horrible fighter, he means a horrible matchup. Because we know Iovine was a horrible fighter. We know Rocky Fielding is a horrible fighter. And they more of a horrible fighter than an Andrade. That's a fact. And he fought them with no problem. But he won't fight Andre to become undisputed. He won't fight a horrible fighter to become undisputed. The reason why he won't is because it's a horrible matchup. That's what Canelo means. What you think of the knockout I displayed on split decision? Now, was that a TKO or was that a KO where he went to sleep for like 2 minutes and I had to wake him up?
Oh, man, that was a murder. That was a beautiful... Yeah, very, very beautiful TKO murder victory. Shit felt like Mortal Kombat to me.
Man, finish him. You know what I'm saying? I had to finish him. But listen, Floyd is like Devin Haney. Floyd, when he was pretty boy, is like Devin Haney today. He was the boogeyman. Everybody was ducking Floyd Mayweather. That's what Floyd Mayweather had to do to become the A-side. You don't just wake up one day, one night, and become the A-side. If you're a fighter on the coincidental list, especially, you got to build your way to become the A-side. So Floyd beat all these fighters, put himself in, not even in the B-side, he put himself in the Z-side against Oscar De La Hoya to get the fight. Yeah. And when he beat him, he then became the A-side. So what I'm saying is the money fights are the legacy fights. The money fights are the biggest fights. If Ryan fight Tank, that's a legacy fight. That's also a money fight. See, that's what people don't get here. Money fights are legacy fights. Devin Haney versus Tank, that's a money fight and a legacy fight. That's the biggest fights of them all.
Devin Haney
versus Shakur, down the line, that's one of the biggest fights of them all, if not the biggest.
Yep.
Errol versus Terrence Crawford, guess what? That's the biggest fight in boxing. So money fights are the legacy fights. People try to twist it and say, oh, you're being a businessman. Like Canelo today, for example. Canelo versus Benavidez is the biggest money fight right now for him, along with Charlo. Canelo versus Charlo is the biggest money fight. It's also a legacy fight. So money fights are legacy fights. You see, Canelo versus Billy Joe Saunders, Canelo versus Caleb Plant, Canelo versus Iovine Yildirim, these aren't legacy fights. These aren't money fights. These are cherry pick fights. These are safe fights. So when people say Floyd Mayweather green print,
those are ducks.
Right. When people say Floyd Mayweather green print is money fights, Floyd Mayweather, he's only a businessman. He's only about the money. Money fights are legacy fights, you dummy. For Max Kellerman, he always say that. He tried to discredit Floyd by saying, oh, he a businessman. No. The money fights are the legacy fights. The Pacquiao fight was the legacy fight for Floyd. Canelo fight was a legacy and a money fight for Floyd. So the point that I'm trying to make is, if fighters follow the Floyd Mayweather green print, we will get all the fights we want. From Ryan versus Tank, from Oscar Valdez versus Shakur, from Teofimo Lopez versus Devin Haney, Errol Spence versus Terrence Crawford, Canelo versus Charlo, back in the day, Wilder versus Anthony Joshua. But these fighters aren't willing to take these money fights because these legacy fights are too risky. Again, money and legacy go hand to hand. That's the Floyd Mayweather green print. Yeah. It's both money and legacy. Floyd Mayweather did that. That's why he became the biggest pay-per-view star of all time. On the other hand, these fighters aren't willing to do it. Like Canelo and these guys today, like Teofimo. He telling Tank, I'm the A-side. I know Tank want to fight Tio. But the problem is, Tio already said, I'm the A-side. He said, if you're not going to recognize me as the A-side, I'm not going to fight you. So guess what? Tank ain't going to entertain that bullshit. He said Canelo Alvarez is following the green print. So we going that route. Andrade was his biggest payday at the time. For Undisputed, his dream that he set for himself. Guess what Canelo Alvarez did? He turned that fight down to fight Kovalev for less money. He cherry-picked a hurt Kovalev, right? Then he switched it up. I made him tap out. He said, oh, it's risk-reward. That's what Floyd Mayweather did. He wanted to fight the biggest bag for the lowest risk. Obviously, Pacquiao for Floyd Mayweather was a big risk. Canelo was a big risk. Canelo was 23 years old in his prime. Canelo Alvarez was a bully at 154. Floyd Mayweather, that was his fifth weight division. And Floyd Mayweather was 37 years old. That was a high risk for Floyd. But why did he take the high risk? Because it's high risk, high reward. Pacquiao was high risk, high reward. Guess what? Canelo Alvarez versus Andrade, high risk, high reward because it's money, right? It's for the bag. Just like Charlo, it's for the bag. Benavidez, it's for the bag. But Canelo turned down every single fight that's for the money, like he claimed. How are you going to compare Canelo to Floyd Mayweather? The million-dollar question is, when is Canelo going to do what Floyd Mayweather did? The green print, right? That's why Canelo continues to flop on DAZN. DAZN never pushed out his ratings because he was cherry-picking, and DAZN did not want to continue to pay him for the cherries he was selecting. When he selected Iovine, a fighter coming off a loss, guess what? DAZN stripped him of his contract because he was cherry-picking.
All right, now check this out, guys. If you're looking to repair eczema scars, burns and bruises, dark spots and blemishes, then this right here is the perfect product for you guys. It's called Elo De Key Face and Body Oil. Athletes and top-ranking boxers, they're also using it after training to reduce swelling and inflammation and to ease the pain. So get yours today. Go to elodekey.com. Like them on Facebook and follow them on Instagram. Fellas, I've got some great news for you. If you've lost your hair or have a receding hairline, the time has come when you can finally get your hairline back through a process called scalp micropigmentation. So here's how it works. It's a hair tattoo that replicates the look of your hair follicles when you have fully shaved it down. So to get this hookup, make sure you follow and contact my man, Scalp Carolinas, on Instagram. Contact them at 704-499-3471 and make sure you follow them on Instagram.